from first unit. The lesson name is Grand Contest in the Forest. In the before lessons you have heard about the peace and harmony. It was the first part. Second part was I Want Peace. It was the poem. And now let us see the C part of unit 1, Grand Contest in the Forest. This is a story about the birds, animals and trees. What things live in the forest? These are birds, animals and things. These all live in the forest. Today we are going to see one more story about a forest. In the forest, animals, birds and trees were preparing for something. What were the preparations for? They were preparing for the great day. What was the great day? How we celebrate different festivals and different occasions like this. Birds, animals and trees also celebrate some occasion. Now in the forest they were preparing for the great day. What they will do on the great day? They have to just present their gifts to the Lord, to the great one, the Lord of fire, wind, sun, water. These all will be the guests of honor and they will select the best prize. How these animals are going to prepare, we are going to see in this lesson. Not only birds, not only animals, trees are also taking part in this competition. Let us see how they are taking part, how they are making the preparations. Now, let us see the first tree, laburnum. Laburnum is a tree which gives yellow bunch of flowers, which the flowers will look like hanging bells. This is the laburnum tree which gives yellow flowers and also bunch of flowers, yellow group of flowers which look like hanging bells. This tree says, how it is getting ready? It says that I will shine like sparkling sunshine. See, this laburnum is getting ready. What is its gift? It wants to give, it wants to spark, it wants to shine like sparkling sunshine. Have you ever observed the sparkling sunshine, how it is very bright? You can't see with your open eyes. It is very, very bright. The same way laburnum tree wants to shine like sparkling sunshine and it wants to wonder the great. Now, Gulmohar tree, it is also a tree which gives red color flowers. It says that I will dress myself like early morning. Have you ever seen the early morning's beauty? It is very, very beautiful. Early morning, the red color, the sun shines in red color and also it will be very soft. See here, I will dress myself like early morning sun. It says that golden red spreading radiance. I will shine like early morning sun spreading radiance. In which color? The early morning sun will be golden red in color. So the Gulmohar says that I will show my beauty. I will spread my flowers like early morning sun. So this is the gift it was going to give to the great one on the great day. The next comes bear. Bear says I will offer the best honey. So what is the bear going to give the Lord? It wants to give the best honey which is collected from the flowers. So next comes elephant. Elephant says, I will get fresh, best fruit. So what is the elephant going to give to the great one? It was going to give fresh and best fruits to the great one. Next comes palash. What is palash? Palash is also a tree which gives red color flowers and people use this palash to pray the Lord. These flowers are used as sacred flowers. These people take this to temples also. So this palash says that I will ablaze the forest with my beauty. It says that I will make the forest so bright. I will lit the forest so bright that it will look very beautiful and the great one will be happy with me. Next comes mango tree. Mango tree says that my mangoes are ready. I will present my beautiful yellow sweet mangoes to the great one. Next comes peacock. Peacock says I will present my feathers, my beautiful feathers, my emeralds and my turquoises are my feathers. What are emeralds? You can see here. I have a chain in my neck which is having green color stone. What is this? This is gem. green color jet. This is called emerald. So the peacock says that it is going to present her feathers, which are like emeralds, green color, gemstones, and also turquoises. What are turquoises? Turquoises are blue gemstones. And this is green gemstone, blue color. Blue color gemstone is called as turquoises. So the peacock says that it is going to present her feathers. How are the feathers? They are looking. We have seen the beautiful colors. Have you ever seen a peacock's feather? Is very beautiful. It looks like emerald and turquoises, which are tucked inside that feather. So this peacock says that I am going to present my beautiful feathers, which look like emeralds and turquoises. Next comes lark. What is lark? Lark is a small bird. It says I will sing a beautiful song. I will sing a melodious song, moving, and I will sing. How she says? She says that I will move and sing. I will move and sing a beautiful song so that the great one will be happy. Next she says dove. Dove cooed. It made a soft sound, and it said that the great one would love her soft notes. I will make so soft notes that the great one will love my soft notes. Then the little last comes the little grey color squirrel. It was very quiet when all these animals were fighting each other. They are saying that I will give this, I will give that. Everybody was getting ready. They started their preparations. It was seeing all the animals and birds and trees are getting something ready, what they can do. But the small grey color little squirrel, which was seeing these all trees, birds and animals, it was very upset. It was thinking itself that what could I give? I am very small. I am very ugly. I have stripes on my body. I have black color stripes on my body. I am gray in color. I am not so beautiful like peacock or any other trees. I can't glow like them. I can't sing like beautiful songs like lark or dove or cuckoo or any other bird. I am not so big like elephant or any other animals. I do not have anything great or anything special to give to the great one. What should I give? All the people, all the birds, animals and trees are getting ready. Their gifts are so grand. What can I give? What should I give? How can I give? Though I am very small, I am not great like them. I am not beautiful like them. I am not able to give such great grand gifts. So what should I? Like this, it kept thinking and was very sad. But however, it made itself and it planned to give something or the other. How she can keep quiet? So it thought of something and started collecting the dry hollow branches. Hollow, like this cylinder, like this pipe type branches. So it started collecting a hollow branches, dry branches, and collected some nuts and shells and kept inside and got ready. It decided to give this hollow branch filled with nuts and seeds. So it decided, okay, if the great one is not happy also, doesn't matter, because everybody is bringing something. How can I keep quiet? So I should also take something, though the great one won't be happy. So everybody was making preparations like this. Labarnam, Palash, Lark, Dove, Elephant, like this. Everybody, all the trees, animals, birds, everybody was making arrangements for the great one. However, like this, day by day, every day they were preparing, and at last the day came. It was the great grand contest day. Who came to that day? The great one, the lords of fire, water, wind and sun all came that day, and there was excitement in the air. Everybody was excited to see the lords, and they started one by one, they started to present their gifts on the great one's feet. Everybody came, they wished the lord and say, this is my gift, great one, please accept my gift. Like this they said and kept on the great one's feet one by one. First came Labarnam, then Gulmohar, then Pear, Elephant, Palash, Mango Tree, Peacock, Lark, Dove. Like this, every creature started to give him their gifts. But our little squirrel kept quiet in the corner. It didn't come forward. It was seeing everything and it was very upset that all the gifts are grand. The great one may be happy with that. If I take this, what may the grand one think? What may the great one think? What the Lord will think that I have got this? It was thinking like that and kept in the corner. But as the great one was observing everything, everybody was coming. But it observed that why this gray color little squirrel is not coming forward. So great one called that gray squirrel and asked, what happened to you, my dear gray color little squirrel? Why are you so quiet? Then squirrel answered that, my great one, I am not so big, I am not so beautiful like other animals or birds. I can't sing like them. I can't glow like them. But what can I give? What? I am very small, very tiny inside, and also I am very ugly, very small creature. What can I give? Everybody is giving so grand gifts. What I can give? But my Lord, whatever I give, I will give with my heart, it said, and it dragged its branches. It dragged the dry branches and kept in front of the Lord. It kept on the feet and said that these are my gifts, my Lord. Please accept my gift. This is the gift which I am giving with my whole heart. Wholeheartedly I am presenting this gift to you. Please accept my gift. Then the great one observed it. There was excitement in the air. Nobody knew that what is going to happen. Who is going to get the prize? Which gift made the great one happy? Everybody was looking the great one. Then the great one took some time and observed all the things and started to say that all the gifts were very beautiful and grand. Everything was colorful, melodious, and so many different gifts. I am very, very happy with all the gifts. But today the best prize will be given to the little gray squirrel. As the announcement was given that the squirrel has won the prize, all the animals and the gray squirrel itself was amazed. It was surprised to hear that all the gifts were very wonderful. But this great one has selected the dry branches, hollow branch, which was filled with just nuts and seeds. What happened? Why the great one liked it? Everybody was excited to hear. Then the great one explained that everybody has presented me very beautiful things which are useful for just present. I can eat the mango now. I can have the beauty. I can feel happy for 1 hour or 2 hours or at the present. But the great little squirrel's gift is the best gift which is useful for me for the future. It is useful for the future generations. What it has given? It has given me dry hollow branches with nuts and seeds. That if we sow these nuts, if we sow these seeds, we are going to get the great big trees in future which will give fruits, flowers, and which will be useful for the coming future generation. So this is the great gift it decided, and the great one gave the prize to the little squirrel. Everybody was happy to hear this. Everybody accepted the decision taken by the great one and all cheered and said that the little gray squirrel, your gift is wonderful. We are so foolish that we have just thought that we can make the great one happy with our presents, which are just useful for the present. But though you are so small, your ideas are very great, your ideas are very big. You have thought for the future. It is very good, very best gift you have selected for the great one. And everybody cheered for the great squirrel. This was the story about grand contest in the forest.